this, and teacher comes up and was like, "What you doing, Timmy?" "I'm drawing a picture of God." And the teacher was trying to be all, you know, neutral, and she's like, "Well, no one, how can you do that? No one has seen God before. How can you draw a picture? How can you, no one has seen God?" And Timmy's like, "They will when I'm done." That's the faith of a child. Would you stand?
How many want to see God? Amen. Yeah, until we get to heaven, our opportunities to see God are still existent. Like when we drive down and see an amazing sunset. When we see multiple colors of leaves, when we see little baby fingers wrapped around ours, when we see birds flying, when we see a sinner come to Christ, when we see the love of people, we've seen God. But let's, this morning as we sing and we get ready to do our worship, let's just make this song our prayer. Lord, open the eyes of my heart so I can see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Say it again, open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Come on, say it again. Open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes. Say, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Oh, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. To see you high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. To see you high and lifted up. Up and shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. You are holy, holy, holy. Come on, tell them. Holy, 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 holy. And I want to see you. You are holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Come on, say it again. You are holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Say, open the eyes of my heart. Say, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Come on, say it again. Open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Please open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. And you are holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Amen. That's our prayer this morning, isn't it?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
You may be seated. Come to church with a prayer that Lord would open our eyes to really see him. That's a good prayer. Good morning and welcome to Ogemaw Hills Church. We're thrilled that you're here to get gathered together to worship him in spirit and in truth. Because of the gift of Jesus Christ and his sacrifice makes available to us everything necessary for life and godliness and the knowledge of who he is. Makes available to us the presence of God today. If you grab your bulletin, just want to point a few things out to you today. We have a few tools from the Stand Strength team. We have a little insert they like to use just to give us a tool to be praying about who to invite to the outreaches. And so please grab that red sheet and use that to list some people that you'd like to invite to the outreaches Friday, Saturday, Sunday evening, where, of course, we'll have a great time with the Stand Strength team, seeing them do what they do with the demonstrations, the feats of strength. But then we're going to hear the gospel presented in clarity each night, too. There'll be a call to response. And so be thinking about who you could invite and be bathing those people in prayer, that they would respond to the invitation, be able to come out and hear the gospel and commit their lives to him now and forever. We have a couple VIP passes in the bulletins as well. Those are good for invitations, and just be praying because God's on the move. This coming Wednesday is going to be a real Jesus opportunity in the schools as we gather at the flagpoles. This is See You at the Pole this coming Wednesday. We'll be gathering at the middle school and at the high school in this area and praying 7 o'clock at the middle school around 8:40 or 7 o'clock at the high school around 8:40 at the middle school. And so the kids will open in prayer, those that come out. And it's always a powerful time and a humbling time to be with the students as they pray. And then Wednesday begins our assemblies with the Stand Strength team in the schools, giving a positive message and calling the kids to good choices and making these direct invitations to all the students for their families and themselves to come here to the church Friday, Saturday, or Sunday for the big outreach events. And so be praying, be praying, be praying. And because some bent bars, some kids lifted in the air, some blocks broken, fun things like that, it has no impact on eternity whatsoever if the Holy Spirit's not moving and souls aren't saved. Amen? We need to be praying. Be praying. And use this as a list to pray through and make invitation. There is no substitute for personal invitation. Nothing, statistically and practically, what we've seen in practice as well. There is no substitute for personal invitation to an event, to faith in Christ, to the Stand Strength outreaches, to church, whatever it may be. There is no substitute for personal invitation. And so please be praying about how God may want to be using you in that way. We have the privilege today of celebrating Freedom Sunday. Freedom Sunday, we take time, we pause, and we consider the epidemic of human trafficking around the world and in our own nation, this devaluing of a human life and used for our own gain, our own pleasure. And so we stand as Christ followers, as Christ would stand against those things. And so on Freedom Sunday, we have an opportunity to consider ways to get involved. You'll see in your bulletin the blue insert some different practical ways to get connected with what God is doing through his church in this area and around the world. You see both sides of that bulletin insert, and we have a video we'd like to take a moment right now to watch as well and consider how we can take a stand for the value of human life.
Thank you. Hey, this is Kevin Austin, director of the Set Free Movement. I am in Cambodia at the House of Love. We in the Set Free Movement are just so delighted to be partnering strong with ICCM in a variety of different ways.
Privilege. We have the ministry missions fair today as well with some of our handful of our ministries through the local church that minister in the church and in the community represented in one of the ministries that we're proud to have set up in the gymnasium that you can kind of tour and get a little more information of all these ministries right after service today is the human trafficking community group is going to be here who works to express value and combat human trafficking here in our immediate area. And so as we take up our offering a little bit later in the service, we'll do our regular tithes and offerings, but if you'd like to include an offering for Freedom Sunday, you can write Freedom Sunday right on there, and that money will go to support local ministry to combat human trafficking and end modern slavery, and to support the three ministries that you just saw in the video as well. And so please consider that. If you'd like to give to Freedom Sunday, just use an offering envelope that you see in the back of the seats there in front of you, and just write Freedom Sunday on that other line, and you can give whatever you'd like. It'll go right to those ministries through the church. So I just want to take a moment and pause and pray. And ask God to move and ask God to use us to change the future. Lord, we thank you for your love for people. We thank you, Lord, because it's your great love that has drawn us to this place today. Your amazing grace that you've poured out into our lives because of the stirring you have toward us. Or, Lord, we don't deserve anything from you, and yet you give out of your overflowing loving nature toward us. We thank you, Lord, for the ministry that you've done and are doing through your people. And we ask you, God, to continue and multiply that ministry to touch hearts, to set people free. Lord, there's people suffering all over this nation, all around the world. And God, we ask you to be their protector and their provider. We ask you to break the chains of slavery in the world today in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask you, Lord, by your grace to help us to know your truth, to hold to your teaching, to truly be your disciples. And then, Lord, we can see you as truth set us free. Lord, we can really know freedom in you. Help us to live in freedom and be ambassadors of that freedom, free agents and givers of that freedom to others. We thank you, Lord. We wholeheartedly celebrate the fact that the one who the Son sets free is free indeed. We thank you, Lord. This freedom knows no national boundaries, no political boundaries. Lord, you can bring freedom to every human heart on the face of the earth. Use us, God, spiritually and practically. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God is good, and God is on the move. God is on the move, reaching people with the love of Jesus Christ. And that's a call on your life and my life and everyday life. right? To reach people with the freedom and the hope of the gospel of Jesus Christ. You know, there's people all around us that we are constantly rubbing shoulders with that are misinformed about their value, is a very mild way to put it. And you and I can show the love of Jesus Christ, the worth that comes implicitly to a soul that understands the gospel. We can be living agents of that gospel and the power of the cross. The cross means that every soul is of infinite worth. And so we treat people that way. We embrace people that way. We serve people that way. We love people that way as Christ followers, because that's the way Jesus does it. And so as we follow him, that's the way we do it, to the glory of his holy name. I want to pause for one more moment and just brag on Jesus and brag on you as God's people, Christ followers here. We began some time ago a Building Beyond Our Building campaign, and we've talked about it just a couple times and had the little pledge cards available in the foyers and put them in the bulletins a time or two. And what the goal is to see the debt of this ministry facility paid off, to better be able to support the ministry in our budget, to reach the needs of the body, reach the needs of the community in a powerful way, and we celebrate that fact. And so our goal was to get out of debt this year, go ahead and get this thing paid off, and continue to see God multiply his ministry, his kingdom, the building of his church beyond the building, as we've seen him do powerfully over the years. And just wanted to brag on Jesus for a moment. When we started this, we owed $107,000on the facility. We now owe $25,000. And we just started it just this year, a little bit ago. So we owe $25,000. We're continuing to make our payments, and so that's going to chip away at some of that too. And just wanted to encourage you to continue to prayerfully consider, is there something that God would have you give? And I know many of you have given much already, not in just this push, but over the years as God has used you as his hands and feet. But just wanted to ask you to consider and pray. And write a $25,000 check today. No. No, but just consider, God is on the move, and we're going to be out of debt by the end of the year by his grace. And so consider being involved in that, and just the great things that God is going to continue to do and multiply among his people. So we wanted to praise God for that, because as the debt dissolves, the interest that would have paid is saved, and we're just thankful for that. And believe it or not, that's about $62,000 of our budget every year is our mortgage. That's a lot of money. I'm glad that's not my mortgage. So we're just thankful for what God's doing, and thankful for what you're allowing him to do through you, and ask you to continue to consider the call as we seek him to wrap this up. And we're going to have a good old party getting rid of that mortgage. Just praise the Lord. Will you stand with me as we turn our attention to the Lord in prayer? And it's a great gift from the Lord to be involved in eternal things. Amen? How much of our life, if we allowed it, would get stolen by the temporal, the temporary, that which we can see, feel, taste, touch, a little redundant in there, the thing that we can physically interact with, would take everything we are, all our focus, all our resources. And God calls you as his sons and daughters to reach into his kingdom as his kingdom reaches into you, into the kingdom of God, and touch eternity. And this is a piece of that. As we gather together on a Sunday, it's not about the physical. It's about connecting with the supernatural God and allowing him to be Lord over everything we see, feel, taste, hear. And so we invite God into this place. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you for your kingdom. And Lord, as we've been talking over the weeks here, we ask that your kingdom would come in this place, in our lives, right now. That your will would be done in this place, in our lives, right now, just as it is in heaven. Lord, come and meet with us as your people. And Lord, we could spend the rest of our lives, literally the rest of our lives, speaking of the greatness of things that you are doing for us and have done. And God, we ask for more. Not for our sake, Lord, but for the sake of your name being rightly made known in the world around us. Lord, advertise yourself through us as your people. And Lord, we know sometimes that That best shows up in times of suffering. We're not asking for you to make everything easy for us, but we want you to use us for eternal purposes. And Lord, may this moment in time you've given us to worship be a piece of that. Come and make yourself known. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Holy God, precious light, I am your sacrifice. For my words aren't enough, so I give you my life. Come and kiss this place. I am humbled by your grace. There is nothing I want more than to feel your warm embrace. Come reveal yourself to me, 'cause you're all I want to see. If I only have one glimpse, it would last eternally. Lord, I long just to see. Take me back to the tree. Show me sweet mysteries of your blood shed for me. Come on down and come and kiss this place. I am humbled by your grace. There is nothing I want more than to feel your warm embrace. Come reveal yourself to me, 'cause you're all I want to see. If I only had one glimpse, it would last eternally. So come reveal yourself to me, 'cause you're all I want to see. If I only have one glimpse, it would last eternally.
Say what last.
It would last eternally. Oh, it would last. Oh, Lord, it would last. It would last eternally. Thank you, Lord. Just one glimpse. Just one glimpse.
Lord, we long to see you. Sing of his love.
He is jealous for me. Love's like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us so. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us so. He's jealous, and he is jealous for me. Loves like a hurricane. I am a tree that's bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. Yes, and he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves. And we are his portion and he is our prize. Drawn to redemption by the grace in his eyes. If his grace is an ocean, we're all sinking. Then heaven meets earth like an unforeseen kiss, and my heart turns violently inside of my chest. I don't have time to maintain these regrets when I think about the way. And oh, how he loves us so. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us so. Yeah, he loves. He loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves us. Oh, how he loves. Yes, he loves.
Lord, you love us. You love us hard. You love us so much. You put yourself on the cross, taking our pain, taking our sin, our rejection. You love us so hard. We pray, Lord, that we are worthy. We pray that we make ourselves, Lord, we put ourselves in a position to just receive what you have for us this morning. We receive that love. We feel unlovable, Lord, make us lovable. If we feel like we can't be forgiven, Lord, show your grace that much, even more. Come out of sadness from wherever you've been. Come brokenhearted, the rescue begin. Come find your mercy, O sinner, come near. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal.
Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal.
So lay it down.
So lay down your burdens. Lay down your shame. All who are broken, lift up your face. Oh, wanderer, come home. You're not too far. Lay down your hurt. Lay down your heart. Come as you are. There's hope for the hopeless and all those who've strayed. Come sit at the table. Come taste the grace. There's rest for the weary, a rest that endures. Earth has no sorrow the heaven can't cure. So lay down your burdens. Lay down your shame. All who are broken, lift up your face. Oh, wanderer, come home. You're not too far. So lay down your hurt. Lay down your heart. Come as you are. Come as you are. And there's joy for the morning. Oh, sinner, be still. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. So lay down your burden. Your shame. All who are broken, lift up your face. Oh, wanderer, come home. You're not too far. So lay down your hurt, lay down your heart, come as you are. Come as you are. Come as you are.
Lord, we have no other way to come to you but just as we are. Lord, thank you for your call to come near. Lord, as we're weary, as we're beaten down, Lord, so many of us need healing in so many ways. Lord, we need forgiveness and perspective. Lord, wholeness. Lord, wash us clean this morning. Cleanse us in your presence. Form us into your image in a deeper way. Heal our brokenness. We come to you, Lord, not because of anything we have to offer. We come empty-handed, Lord. Through faith in Jesus Christ, the one who has made your presence available. And we ask you to do what only you can do as our Father, as our healer, as our provider, as the chain breaker. We thank you, Lord. We praise you, God. We give ourselves to you entirely. We worship you as we do. In Jesus' name we pray. Our only hope, our Savior, our Redeemer. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. You may be seated.